Well, welcome to episode 3 of The Live Room. And in the studio, we have the lovely Claire Hamill. Hello, Claire.
Hello, Harvey.
Do you want to talk about some of the songs that you've picked to play for us today?
Yes, I'll be doing a couple of songs from my latest album, The Meeting of the Waters. The song itself was inspired by a trip to Ireland to a place called The Meeting of the Waters near Avoca. I had a friend who used to live in Avoca, and I visited her with one of my best friends, and we went to this place called The Meeting of the Waters, and I thought it was a beautifully poetic title. And so I wrote the first verse, but I couldn't finish it until last year when I finished it. That was 10 years. 10 years later, I finished the song.
Wow.
Yeah.
It's funny that, isn't it? Sometimes you get that one chunk and then it just sits.
Yeah.
And then, yeah, it's that's great to just magically get the other bit of inspiration all that time later.
Yeah, it is. Fantastic. Really. It's a nice feeling, especially if you loved what you did and you always had it there in the back of your mind, I must finish that song. Often you'll write something and at the time you go, oh God, that's so cheesy. And then when you go back to it later, you go, oh, I really love it. Because for some reason you've changed, you know, your taste has changed, times have changed.
And just how you feel on the day.
Just how you feel on the day, yeah.
Absolutely. Yeah.
She was sweet, 16, and never been kissed. And her eyes had never known tears. He'd be 19 come this July, and he'd watched her bloom for years. Of all John Brennan's girls, she was the most protected daughter, till he whispered, come at midnight to the meeting of silvery beam. She heard the song of the nightingale as she stepped along the stream. He kissed her there and led her like a lamb into the slaughter, and she gave away her virtue at the meeting of the water. John Brennan rose up a broken man and raging to his son, as his daughter pleaded with him still, he went to fetch his gun, and he swore he'd make her lover pay for all the shame. The Meeting of the Waters from my latest album called The Meeting of the Waters. And this is also a song from that album inspired by a radio show I heard about wild swimming, people that swim in rivers and streams.
Mm-hmm. making ripples. But when it's cold, it freezes. You can hear it cracking. Then the shards and the splinters melt in the sun. Let's go, let's feel. So silent, high on a hill, the sun's coming up. Smell the season, is it autumn or golden buttercups? On the day the rains came, it was a great relief. Relief on the day that the rains came. While swimming, life giving is frosty execution to make you feel alive. You are alive, so show it. Forget the world and its disaster.
German girlfriend called Gailey, very sweet girl, and she one day she said to me, oh, the last shirt has no pockets. And I went, what? She went, oh, you must know this phrase, the last shirt has no pockets. And I went, no, I've never heard of that, the last shirt. But it wasn't about you know, about dying and not taking anything with you. That's what it means, you know. I suppose it means don't get hung up on worldly possessions.
Sure.
Because we're not going to need them where we're going. But I turned it into a love song about saying goodbye to a man that you loved. And you know, I mean, men's shirts are a big thing in women's lives. We wash them, we iron them, we hang them up, we put them away. And it was about the last contact with a man, you know, because you were saying, he was saying goodbye or you were saying goodbye.
Yeah.
It's ambiguous. I think actually I was the one that was being left in the song.
Right.
And it was, you know, the smell of him, you know, the nearness, the touch of his shirt, you know, and that was disappearing out of my life.
I see my life fly past. this is my private hell. Remember me as if I could have been your one true love, a bright but such a bitter flame that has branded my heart with your name. Do
to sing one of my new songs for you. I wrote it for Christy Moore to sing. So if anybody knows Christy Moore and they hear this song, please try and get it to Christy Moore, because I think he would do a really good version of it.
Because I'm a troubadour, I don't live anywhere. Each place I lay my hat to call my home. Yes, I'm a troubadour, if you've a bed to spare. Sure, we can kiss and cuddle all night long. And in the morning when you wake up, I'll be gone. I used to have a family, I was the favorite son. But everything went wrong when music came along. I left to get a record deal when I was 21. Me ma said, watch out son, they're gonna burn you. I had a girl in Waterford across the Irish Sea. And when I went away, she said she'd wait for me. But now she's got another man who's twice as big as me. So there's another place I can't return to. Cause I'm a troubadour, I don't live anywhere. Each place I lay my hat to call my home. Yes, I'm a troubadour, if you've a bed to spare. Sure, we can kiss and cuddle all night long. And in the morning when you wake up, I'll be gone. Town that I have chanced along, I'd be the richest man who ever sang a song. But what's the good of fortune when you're always on the run? Besides, you need a lass to help you spend it. There was a girl in Darlington who really caught my eye. And I'll not tell a lie, sure, she made me swoon and sigh. But then she mentioned marriage, boys, and that's the reason why. 2 months down the road, I had to end it. Cause I'm a troubadour, I don't live anywhere. I lay my hat to call my home. Yes, I'm a troubadour, if you've a bed to spare. Sure, we can kiss and cuddle all night long. But in the morning when you wake up, I'll be gone. I'll be gone. lights out, and if I know the tune, I'll happily oblige, and we can raise the room. But if you never fill my glass, I won't be back here soon. So landlord, do the honors, I've a thirst on. And thank you very kindly all for listening to my tale about the foolish Irish boy, the one who got away. But we'll have to leave the rest of it until another day. There's a train that's leaving soon, I'll be the first on. Cause I'm a troubadour, I don't live anywhere. Each place I lay my hat to call my home. Yes, I'm a troubadour, if you've a bed to spare. Shall we can kiss and cuddle all night long. But in the morning when you wake up, I'll be gone.
Don't prolong the agony. I think I'll do this one.
this time for us to be alone. Table's late now, let's join in your game. The moon is a powerful lover. He comes to uncover my wildest of words when I cry out for you. How soon will you tell her you love her?
Recording, I go at the end, I go, Lava. It's so much fun. That's an old one from the 80s.
And there's another song you're going to play, Is This War a Just War? Which is a very, very poignant song. And you've written a few war songs, haven't you?
I have. My first foray into the world of political writing was when my youngest brother joined the army. And he was sent to fight in Northern Ireland, even though he was extremely young and probably shouldn't have been there. And that was my first war song, a song about war. And it's not a very endearing song in that I have very mixed feelings about war, because, of course, sometimes you need to stand up and fight for freedom.
True.
And for the rights of people. But sometimes you're looked on as a bit of cannon fodder, and we realise that now, looking back through history at certain wars that we've gone into, and now we can stand back and say, well, why were we fighting for that reason? But in Northern Ireland, that was a kind of insidious kind of war, and started off Catholics, Protestant, maybe religious bias to it. But when my brother went there, it was like the whole thing very much came home to me. And so I wanted to write about that. I later wrote a song about the Falklands War. And that's kind of a little bit more... it's got a haunting thing about... Come on, it's called Come Along, Brave Lad. So it's about being brave, doing your bit for your country. So I guess in some ways it eulogises war a little bit more, but also there's that last verse where, you know, where the reality of war comes home. And similarly with Is This War Just War, the Iraq War, which we never kind of felt that, you know, we were going in for the right reasons because the UN weren't supporting it.
Sure.
We went anyway. And then it turns out actually afterwards that, you know, there weren't any weapons of mass destruction. So yeah. Is this war a just war? Only time will tell.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Such an emotive subject, but something that I don't think people write enough songs about. You know, the world's full of love songs and things like that. And songs that talk about real... meaningful things like this don't often get the airing they deserve.
No, I think we probably haven't got a good enough idea about the power that we have. And of course, that's how governments want to keep it.
Absolutely.
And, you know, there may be very good reasons for that, because really, you can't let society break down. If society breaks down, nobody wins.
Sure.
So you have to keep it together. Look what's happened in the Philippines. You know, they've had a natural disaster and society's breaking down in certain areas, and it's all gone to pot. Of course, it'll all come back because the rest of the world is fine and we'll all go and help and we'll help you tidy up. And, you know, it's not to do with... there's no kind of war zone there.
Yeah.
But I think if there was a way that people could actually voice their opinions... a bit stronger, and for that to be effective higher up, then I think the world would quickly become a better place. But we've got we've got the only way of doing it, which is through a vote, and that's a very fair at the moment way of doing it.
It's the best we've got, isn't it?
Yeah,
really?
It's the best we've got. This is my tribute to the people who've given their lives in Iraq.
Look at all the soldiers going off to war. The streets ring with the sounds we've heard in times before. We stand needs a platform, not a place to hide. In some foreign field, there lies a young man's bones. Never made a general, never made. Him his glory if he would stand his ground. Now we must tell his story, his name tag can't be found. They gave birth to a country called suffer in this day. most women just want babies, and the men a decent wage. I was just a girl when they tried to ban the bomb. We've had 60 years of peace, now tell me where that's gone. Guess I can hear of the shells. Is this war a just war? Only time will
Right, this next song is about being in love with your flatmate. I was in love with my flatmate some years ago, and I wrote this song for him.
Always friends, but never lovers, though their bedrooms were together. Many times she kept all her smiles for others, and she always looked disinterested when he'd repeat all of his crimes. She would introduce him to her girlfriends, always blondes, cause they're the ones that he'd prefer. And sometimes he'd say, what do you think of Susie? She's not much to look at, but there's really something there. And she would try so hard to be up whenever he was in. And when his influential friends came round, she pretended not to know who they were. But all the cakes she baked him, and all the little notes, just hurt her every time. She'd realize that he didn't care. Sister, and take her out sometimes when her other men forgot, and when the girls who loved him cried upon her shoulder, she would tell them all he really did love them quite a lot. And she would try so hard not to laugh at all of his jokes, and the day she left the bathroom door unlocked, she really did feel bad. But all the cakes she baked him, and all the little notes, just hurt her every time. She'd realize that he didn't care. Always friends, but never lovers, though it wasn't for want of trying that it was that way. But it looked like always friends, and never
trip to America when I was 17 was pretty mind-blowing. I mean, that was a long time ago. The Vietnam War was still on, but it was in its last stages. So boys, I think, oh no, actually maybe it was just winding up. So I think the draft was just finishing. But America is an amazing country to anybody who's never been. I think we live in an amazing world. It's so incredible, so beautiful. For me, a young girl from the northeast of England, America was pretty mind-blowing. And I met this lovely boy there in North Carolina and fell madly in love with him, and he became the inspiration for lots of my songs. But he took me to a place called the Outer Banks, which is in North Carolina, and it's very beautiful, very wild and windswept. And he was surfing, so he went surfing, right. And I played my guitar on the beach like a little beach bunny.
Folk, singer-songwritery stuff, and even, of course, the fabulous album Voices, which is different again.
Yeah.
And it's lovely to sort of be able to reinvent yourself and do all of those different things. It keeps things new and fresh and interesting. And do you feel there's any particular area you're really drawn to more than others, or do you find you're just inspired by different things at different times?
That's a very good question. I think I am inspired to do things at different times. Mm. I like challenge. I like to be fresh, yes. The idea of of music becoming jaded is a very sad one for me. You know, I'd hate to, you know, to become jaded by anything. And so I like to experiment. And I think there's still things I'd like to do. And all kinds of music interest me. I've done even little classical type things as well, you know. And I think that I've been lucky that I've been supported at various times in my life by people who've enabled me to experiment. Yeah. And that's been a joy.
And of course, your current album is The Meeting of the Waters.
Yes.
And whereabouts would you say you're at now in terms of style with
well,
that particular
Well, I think The Meeting of the Waters is much more folky and much more back to my roots. It's a very accessible sort of album. It's not complex in so many ways. It's you know, it's got some light-hearted songs on it. It's got some deep songs on it. And I suppose I just wanted to get a collection of songs that I'd written that I liked and I was fond of and just gather them together in one place, you know, for people to listen to. It's not got a particular theme, but it is more folky. And I think I would like to go more into maybe a bit more experimental at some stage. I probably will do another Voices album.
Right.
I'll probably do another dance-influenced album. I'm sure to do something else with Andrew Warren at some stage.
Sure.
And I'd like to do something that was more classical-based as well, because I've done a collection of music where I've taken classical pieces of music and written lyrics to them. I don't think I sang any today, but that's something else I'd like to explore. So, yeah.
And of course, the future is an interesting thing as well, because you've got a book coming out, I believe, as
That's right, yeah, I have.
An autobiography.
Yeah.
And what was the working title?
How to Be a Rock Chick.
Love it. And so, where does the book start and where does it end?
Well, really, it has to start
without giving the game away.
It's just really about my life, but also about the lessons I learned looking back. You know, when you look back on your life and you think, oh my God, why did I do that? Why did I say that? Why did I do, you know, why did I believe that? All of the things that you think, I wish I'd done something differently. You know, all these regrets, I have no regrets. I've got tons of regrets. You know, I think a life without regrets is a life not lived, because, you know, things impact on you and you do things for a certain period of time because of this idea or that idea. And I think it's very interesting for me to actually go through my life and look back and see the stages where I was, why I was thinking that and, you know, why I did that.
It must be fascinating, because as you grow, you change. And looking back, I mean, I wouldn't even remember what happened years ago. I don't really remember what happened yesterday. But
We've both got short-term memory loss.
But did you find that you had diaries or photographs that helped with the process, or just...
No, I never took photographs. I really regret that now, especially as... In this day and age, there's so much, you know, evidence, so much footage, so many photos of people that, in fact, sometimes a bit too many. You know, it's like people are living their own lives in the glare of the spotlight. Why? And why, you know, be private, you know. But I think there is pressure on people that make their living in a public way to do that, and fine, if that's the way you want it, then that's the way we'll do it. In the early days when I first started, I was just so busy living it, enjoying it, being in the moment. I always forgot to take a picture. I have got some blurry pictures that probably will go in the book, just to prove I was there at the time I say I was. But generally speaking, I didn't much keep any sort of evidence of what was going on. But I've got a good memory.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So when's the book being published?
I'm hoping that it's going to be out next summer.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
We'll look out for that.
Great.
And is there anything else you'd like to say while we're here?
No, just how much I've enjoyed it.
Oh, well, that's lovely. Thank you so much, Claire Hamill.
My pleasure.
Make sure you buy Claire's fantastic new album and remember to subscribe to our channel. And thank you for watching, Claire Hamill. Thank you very much.
Thank you. It's been my great pleasure to sing for you. So I would just like to finish now on a little song Truth, Beauty and Happiness, and it's from my album The Meeting of the Waters. Last night I reached out and I touched you. It was like ice falling on fire, and a storm blew up and the lights went on, and I suddenly is truth, beauty and happiness, and the love in your eyes. I know there've been so many times when I gave up and I almost gave in to the wild wind and the storm clouds, but you just kept pushing me. There's a big world out there. I want my share and then I'll be home, back where I belong. Last night I reached out and I kissed you. It was like falling into my death, and time stopped. Truth, beauty.